Hi everyone. I hope everyone is safe and having fun with your kids. Today we are here with 10 worksheets for sight words. First, let's talk about introducing sight words to the kids, and then let's see the simple worksheets to complex worksheets. Once we are done with the worksheets, I am even going to talk about one of the book which we use for practicing sight words at the end of the video. Let's dive into it. For the first worksheet, I've kept it really simple. We have taken 5 sight words. We generally teach 5 sight words at a time for worship so that he does not get confused when so many sight words are introduced at a time. So I will teach 5 words at a time. Once he is memorizing the 5 words, then I will bring in the next set of 5 words. So currently he's learning these 5 words. So I've given a matching activity where he needs to read the first sight word and match it with its on the right hand side. So it's a simple worksheet so that he gets familiarized and he identifies the sight words which are being taught to him. Now let's see the second worksheet. So if you see this worksheet, it's a raindrop of sight words which are colorful raindrops, and there are some umbrellas. So Varshit would need to go and read the first sight word of. He would go and look in the umbrella and he would be coloring umbrella pink. Wherever the word off is there, he's going to color pink. So he's going to match it. So the similar way, he's going to decode all the sight words and color these umbrellas. The third worksheet is also something related to brain boosting itself. So if you observe, these are the 6 worksheets I would want him to revise. So he's going to first read these 6 sight words, and then I'll tell him that, do you see 6 boxes? Each box has a missing sight word. Can you read them and identify which sight word is actually missing? Once he identifies it, he's going to write it in this space. So this way, the same sight word would be practiced at least 6 times, because for each box, he's going to read all the sight words and he's going to identify which one is missing. So around 6 times, the same sight word would be practiced, but it will be in a fun way. And coming to the next worksheet, if you observe, these are the new sight words that he's currently learning. So this way, I generally mix and match. I give one worksheet for the ones which he is learning new and one worksheet for revising the old ones. So that way he is actually remembering the old ones and he is learning the new ones also. For this worksheet, there are 6 sight words here which are colored in different circles. So he is going to identify those words here. He is going to take the same color and circle them up. Once he circles all of the sight words, he can even go ahead, count them up and write the value in the top box. For example, if he is going to take come, he's going to take pink color pen and he's going to read out come and circle it, come, come, and he's going to circle it. So this way he is going to circle all the words come, and at the end he can even count them up and write the value in the box. For the next worksheet, I really wanted to make it something interesting for him instead of just matching or practicing it up. So what I've done is I've given him a puzzle and I've given some words on the top. So what he would do, he would start picking up the first word and he will look for the same word. Is there a there here? Is there a there here? Once he identifies it, he's going to circle it like this. So that way he's going to find out all the words in this puzzle, and once he is done, he can even practice the same in the below space that I've given for him. So these are some of the worksheets that we use for practicing sight words. But it's not only worksheets that we do with Varshit, we even play some games for learning sight words. So I'm going to show 3 of the games that we play. The first one is a tic-tac-toe. You can use coins for this game, but I generally use broken crayons like this so that it's more interesting for him. So I will ask Varshit to start with the game. He's going to pick up one of the box, read the sight word and place his coin. For example, if he's going to pick up this box, he's going to read there and keep his coin here. And now it's my turn. So I'm going to say, okay, I would take this box, which is here. So this way we would be going on turns to read out the sight word and place our coins, something like this. So let's say this is the box structure that is there. Then Varshit can actually go ahead and read the word your, and he's going to place a coin here. With this, he will form a line and he's going to win the game. Of course, it's not going to be that simple. I would wait for him to finish most of the sight words so that he can practice most of them. I would give him a chance till the end, and depending on the time and the mood, he would sometime win, I would sometime win. But that's okay. He would generally be very sportive and he would say, it's okay, I did not win this time, I would really want to play again so that I want to win next time. This way we would keep on repeating the game until he has interest and he would be finishing the practice also. Now let's see the second game. This is a simple snakes and ladder game where most of us have been played in our childhood. but I've made it a little more interesting by bringing some sight words here. How do we play it? It's a usual game where you use some coins and dice and you would start moving from the start. But only change here is when the kid is moving from box to box, I would actually want him to read the word and then move. Let's say if the dice is 3, so it's going to start here. You're into like. So he's going to practice the sight words and he's going to even play the game until the end. And for the next game, it's a die game where I've given 2 boxes, one for Varshit and one for me. There are 6 sight words in each of them. So for this one, we would actually roll a die. Let's say if it's number 1. So we're going to decode it to ease and both of us will cross the word ease. Once we start crossing the words, whenever there is a line, the line can be like this or like this. So whenever we reach a line, we are going to cross it out and mark the number. Whoever is going to reach the 3 lines first would actually win this game. So this way he would be even practicing the 6 sight words that are here and he would be even playing the game. But let's say if the same sight word comes up once again, if the die is going to roll back to 1 once again, then he is going to just read out the word. He will not be crossing it out again. These are the 3 games that we actually play for fun at the same time learning our sight words. But other than these 3, I do have 2 more practice worksheets. Frankly speaking, I don't give these worksheets very often. I generally give them once in a month or so because it's a long worksheet. He might get bored. So that is the reason I give once in a month so that he revises all the sight words that he knows till the date. So if you observe, these are the sight words that he already know. All of them are written in one single page. So how would we do this? If he's in a mood to complete all the worksheets, I would just ask him to start reading from first sight word A and color it up. You can even give him a marker or you can give him a stamp or something so that he's going to read the word and he's going to stamp it up. But let's say if he has done until here, this point, and he gets bored and he's saying, no, I don't want to do anymore. So then I will make it a little more fun, saying that, okay, till now you have done it on your own. Now I'm going to ask you a word. It's a scavenger hunt now. It's a treasure hunt. So once I ask you a word, you find it up for me and then stamp it up. Like for example, if he's done till here, so these ones are gone. So I'm going to search a word in the below ones. If I say if, is going to find it and stamp it. And similarly, there's one more practice worksheet that I give it to him, which is like this. So I make a box something like this and I write the sight word actually on the top. What I would ask him to do is take a gel pen or anything that he loves. It can be a new pencil or a new crayon or whatever he's interested at the moment. And I would actually ask him to repeat the word in the same box. Since he would be interested in pens like this, colorful pens like that, he would say go ahead and start practicing the words as well. So these are the worksheets that I wanted to share with you today. Now that we are done with the worksheets, now let's see the book that I use for my 3-year-old and 5-year-old so that they have some reading time at the same time learning the sight words. We've got this book from Amazon and it's not that expensive also. I will link the book in the description box. It's a level 1 sight word. As the level goes higher, the complexity of the sight words would increase. So this book has about 55 sight words. So these are the 55 sight words that are part of this book. So how does the book look like inside? Let's say if you're teaching the sight word I, so he is going to read out I here. And then if you observe, it's the same sight word that is repeating, but with an action. For example, you can say, what is this? It is I sleep, I skate, I swim. So this way you can actually ask him to read the sight word and identify the action so that he can read the full sentence. So if you see for the word like, it's the same thing. I has already been taught to you. You can read I. Now you can read like. And what do you like? I like pizza. I like bananas. I like apple. So this is how the whole book would go into. So if you see, as the pages go in, it becomes a little complex. Now if you go to the third page, you are going to teach my. I has been already taught the kid. Like has been taught. Now you're teaching my. I like my dog. I like my cat. So this way, whatever is the sight words that has been revised or taught before will be used in the next pages as well. Like if you see, I see my, I like my. So these are the words that have been taught till this page. So not only this C word is used, but even the old words are being revised as part of the same page. So that has been very useful actually for revising as well. As the pages go on, the words become complex, and by the end, the kid will be able to read the sentences like this, which are very simple, and most of the sight words will be there as part of these sentences. So that's it for today. I hope the worksheets, games, and the activities that I've shown would be useful for your kids. Do let us know in the comment section. We do have printable version of the games that I've shown you. So if you are interested, do let us know in the email. The email ID is there in the description box as well. I hope these worksheets have been useful, and thank you so much for all the support that you have been showing towards us. Have a good day.